Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we'll talk about the means of communication in Egypt in the 50s and the early 60s at that time. We used to listen to the radio. The radio was the only source of information, only source of amusement, apart from cinema, which used to go to sometimes, theater, which was there. But actually for the family at home was the radio. Drama, singing, dancing, poetry, politics, news, culture, everything. And the best nights we used to spend in our house in Al-Hilmiyya is during Ramadan. When after having our iftari, we used to bring the nuts and the chestnuts. Nuts, which is like hazelnuts and almond and other. And we used to bring the chestnut and grill it and eat it. Listening to what? Listening to the story of Al-Fidr, the 1000 Nights and Nights, which was read from the book of 1000 Nights and Nights between Shahrayar, which was actually the king, and Shahrazad, which was the lady or the mistress or the servant who used to every night to tell him a fairy story before he goes to bed. And actually the why? Because he said, if you don't entertain me before sunrise, I'll kill you. And she used to give him the bedtime story till he goes to sleep, and she was saved at the time. This was from the book of 1000 Nights and Nights. The good thing about it is, you can imagine when you hear, you can imagine when you hear the voices of animals, lion, zebra, donkey, monkey, flying birds, waterfalls and rivers and horses and. That we used to imagine the scenes and the images of this, and this gives us a very powerful way of creativity coming from imagining what is mentioned there in practical way. And the whole family used to listen to this during Ramadan. During the 60s, Nasser, or the regime, introduced the television. It was black and white television. It was actually for the whole day. I think it was for a few hours every day. And every Thursday, my mother's family, members of my mother's family, used to come and spend the night and watch the television, because it was a big, big news. I'm not sure how much the television was at that time, maybe £40 or £50, but my father, because of his broad vision to not to deprive his children from having any tool of amusement at home, he bought the television for us there and used to enjoy it. But the quality of the presenter is absolutely different from what we see nowadays. The values of television at that time, the morality in the television, the drama on the television, even the code of dress of the presenters on television was absolutely different to what we see of this filth we are seeing it nowadays. And this is something which actually impacted our life as well, or my life as well. The third one, which actually, the hand radio with the battery, not sure what you call it, we used to call it transistor at the time, which came out in the 60s as well and was sold available to everybody in the area. But the good thing about it is that when you walk in the street, you find somebody on the other side of the road actually holding this radio in himself, with the antenna there, and in a loud voice, listening to a song, listening to a music, listening to the news, and everybody is saying, oh, why? Subhanallah, there's a radio, people are talking, and they're making a joke about those people at the time. So from the time of the radio and the strong imagination which has impacted my life personally, to the black and white television, to the transistor era at the time, actually this impacted the growing culture of the young growing child in this area, which is still impacting myself nowadays. I feel sorry for the young people nowadays, because the power of their imagination is not as strong as the power of the imagination we had in the past. And this is what you find now, the difference between the poetry of the past and the current poetry, because there is no much imagination and strength and deep culture into it. Thank you very much for listening to the video. I wish that you can activate the notification bell and share it with your colleagues. Wassalamu alaikum.